Dear students, once again I welcome you. I hope you all are safe, taking all the precautions, staying at home to beat the COVID-19 crisis. प्यारे विद्यार्थियों, आपका एक बार फिर स्वागत है और मुझे विश्वास है कि आप COVID-19 को बीट करने के लिए सारे प्रिकॉशंस ले रहे हैं। मेरे लेक्चर सीरीज में आज मैं एक बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट चैप्टर को स्टार्ट करने जा रहा हूँ। स्टूडेंट्स, इस चैप्टर की जो बैकग्राउंड है वो हिस्टोरिकल है। इस चैप्टर को मैं इंट्रोड्यूस कर रहा हूं एक यूनिक वे में। शायद आप समझ पाएंगे कि इनोवेशन, एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन, ऑब्जर्वेशन की क्या पावर है और फिजिक्स कितना एक्साइटमेंट से फुल सब्जेक्ट है। तो मैं स्टार्ट कर रहा हूं एनसीईआरटी का लेसन नंबर 4, मूविंग चार्जेस एंड मैग्नेटिज्म। तो इस वीडियो को देखकर आप क्या क्या अचीव करेंगे इस टॉपिक में, इस टॉपिक के क्या क्या लर्निंग आउटकम्स होंगे जब ये आप कंप्लीट कर चुके होंगे वीडियो, तो आई एम श्योर कि आपको इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और मैग्नेटिज्म का हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड पता चल जाएगा। यू विल बी अवेयर अबाउट द हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड मैग्नेटिज्म। यू विल बी अवेयर अबाउट द एक्सपेरिमेंट परफॉर्म बाय Hans Christian Oersted. We will discuss this experiment also. You will be familiar about magnetic force, Lorentz force, magnetic field by electromagnet, and you know learning is a fun. This is the apparatus used by the Hans Christian Oersted to perform the experiment. So you will experience the joy of virtual learning through this video. You will enhance your learning capabilities and you will assess yourself also. Definitely joy of learning is different from other type of enjoyments. Learning is a fun, learning is a joy. So let us start historical background of electricity and magnetism. You know, electricity and magnetism were known to the scientists more than 2000 years. However, it was only about 200 years ago when they came to know that electricity and magnetism are not separate. They are intimately related. And in 1820, the great physicist and chemist, Danish physicist Hans Christian Oersted, noticed that a current in a straight wire caused a noticeable deflection in a nearby magnetic compass needle, and this was accidentally observed by him. And this observation opened a new era for this world. And what was that? That moving charges or electric current produce magnetic field. एंड दिस इज द ग्रेटेस्ट डिस्कवरी इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द साइंस दैट मूविंग चार्जेस और इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इन ए कंडक्टर प्रोड्यूस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इन सराउंडिंग स्पेस. सो आफ्टर दिस रिमार्केबल ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ द ऑरस्टेट मैनी एक्सपेरिमेंट्स वर परफॉर्म. In 1864, a new dimension explored by the James Maxwell. He had unified the electricity and magnetism through some laws and realized that light was nothing but electromagnetic wave. After that, Hertz discovered radio waves. And then J.C. Bose and G. Marconi were successful to produce the radio waves. So this is the historical experiment, historical outcome, the Hans Christian Oersted had given to the world, or I can say has given to this world. Now, let us watch the experiment performed by the Hans Christian Oersted. You can see on your screen where my cursor is moving, photograph of great scientist, physicist, chemist, Hans Christian Oersted. Student, this is the YouTube link of this video. Now students, question arises, why does a moving charge create magnetic field? Before playing this video, I would like to highlight few things. As we know, static charges produce electric field, and electric field denoted by capital E, and moving charges produce magnetic field, and this is denoted by capital B, and this is the vector field. R is the position of the point. And both electric and magnetic fields are vector fields. So both electric and magnetic fields are identical in some respect. They have some analogy, comparison, similarity. One of the important similarity is that both obey the principle of superposition. The magnetic field of several sources is the vector addition of magnetic field of each individual source. This is important. So now, what is the answer of this? Why does a moving charge create magnetic field? Our respected Professor S.C. Verma video is attached here, and I feel proud to attach this video here. So students, let us start magnetic force and Lorentz force. Magnetic force or Lorentz force kya hai? Iske baare mein jante hain? So let us consider a point charge small q, moving with a velocity small v, and at any point of time small t, its location is r. Now this moving charge is exposed to both electric field and magnetic field. Electric field is capital E and magnetic field is capital B at that point R. So now force on electric charge due to both of them, that is force due to electric field and magnetic field on this charge, can be written like this. See, this is the force. Combined force, net force due to electric field and magnetic field, and this is the expression for this force. Q is common in bracket electric field plus vector product of velocity and magnetic field. दिस इज कॉल्ड लॉरेंस हॉर्स एंड दिस हॉर्स वॉज फर्स्ट गिवन बाय साइंटिस्ट एच ए लॉरेंस बेस्ड ऑन द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स ऑफ एम्पियर एंड अदर्स. सो नाउ व्हाट इज लॉरेंस फोर्स? लॉरेंस फोर्स इज ए फोर्स produced by both electric field and magnetic field on a moving charge. And this magnetic force depends upon, you see, charge, velocity and magnetic strength and magnitude of the magnetic field. If we change the nature of the charge from positive to negative, the direction of force will be reversed. This is the main point to remember here. So this is the idea about magnetic force and Lorentz force. Magnetic force, force experienced by moving charge and magnetic field. Lorentz force, force applied by both magnetic field and electric field or moving charge. This force is Lorentz force. Now I have come up to very important slide, demonstration of magnetic field. Before going to demonstrate the magnetic field through some simulation activity, I would like to point out few important things here. And you already know about the electromagnet. This is artificial magnet which run on moving charges, that is current. And what is electromagnet? This is a coil. Coil wrapped on an iron bar. This coil is often called solenoid. So this experiment is showing how the magnetic field is produced by this solenoid which is carrying current, and we call it electromagnet. So let us watch a simulation activity. See, this is just a magnet. You see, this is a magnet. North, south, you have seen the magnet in your previous classes also. This is magnetic compass and these arrows are showing magnetic field. This is the magnetic field produced by a magnet. You see, when we change the position of this magnetic needle, the alignment of magnetic needle changes. See, these are magnetic field lines. You know about this, that magnets produce magnetic field, and we can test the magnetic field through magnetic compass. This red end of the magnetic needle is north and white end is south. So see, magnetic needle itself a magnet, very small magnet. So this south pole of magnetic needle is attracted by the north pole of the magnet. But our aim to study the field produced by solenoid. See, this is solenoid, charges are moving. This is positive terminal of the solenoid. This is negative terminal of the solenoid. Charges are moving in copper wire. Direction of charge, you can see how from negative terminal to positive terminal, electrons are moving. And see, this is the field produced by current carrying conductor. Here, current carrying conductor is solenoid, that is electromagnet. This is battery. And this is magnetic field. See, if I bring this magnetic needle near this end of the solenoid, see, north pole is attracted by this end of the solenoid. It means this end of the solenoid is south and this is north. If I bring this magnetic needle here, now see, south pole is attracted by this end of the solenoid, this end is north. So this is beautiful activity showing the presence of magnetic field, and here no magnet is there. made up of iron or all that. This is electromagnet. See, electrons are moving in the solenoid. See, if we decrease the loop of the solenoid, magnetic field becomes weak. If we increase the number of loops in the solenoid, magnetic field becomes strong. We can check it with the meter also. See, this is the meter. If I bring this meter near the end, see, magnitude is changing. See, magnitude is 13.98 gauss. And X component is 8.86 and Y component minus 10.82. If I take away this meter, see, magnetic field is just 0.26. If I place here, see, direction of Y component changing. If I place here, direction of Y component is negative, here direction of Y component is positive. So direction of magnetic field has changed. This is the meter which is measuring the strength of the magnetic field. If I reduce number of turns, see how the magnetic field reduces. So right now our topic is not this the field of solenoid, just this simulation activity clears the concept how the moving charges produce magnetic field around it. This I am showing through this magnetic needle also and through this meter also. If I change the polarity, you know, if direction of current is changed, let us change the direction of current. Now see, electrons are moving from this point to this point, from negative terminal towards the positive. I change the polarity. Now see what happens. See, direction of electrons is reversed, direction of charge is reversed in the conductor. So when direction is reversed, see, magnetic field also reverses. This magnetic compass is here to show this change. See, if I change this terminal to positive, see, this red end of the compass is attracting towards this end. It means this end is the south end of the solenoid. If I take this to change the polarity, now direction of electrons is reversed. See, the direction of magnetic needle also reverse. So if direction of flow of charge is reversed in the conductor, direction of magnetic field also reverses. So this is how we can understand this concept that moving charges produce magnetic field. I have explained through meter, field meter as well as needle. Both are showing that there is presence of magnetic field around this solenoid. Although there is no magnet, this is electromagnet. If we stop passing the current, this magnetic field will not be there. Now one more thing, this battery is now DC, direct current. Direct current is stable current, producing constant stable magnetic field. If I change this current to AC, now see what is happening. Alternating current, direction of alternating current changes. So continuously, see, this is the supply, positive, negative, positive, this terminal, polarity of this terminal is changing continuously, plus minus, plus minus, plus minus. Same is happening with the magnetic field also. See, direction of magnetic field is reversing. And same is showing meter also. Positive, negative, positive, negative. I have increased the amplitude, strong AC. Here I can change. I have reduced the frequency. So just a glimpses of AC and DC current through this simulation. But our aim is to understand that moving charges produce the magnetic field. This is the main aim of showing this simulation activity to all of you. I hope you have enjoyed. This is FET simulation, PHET. You can visit this website, you can search on Google PHET simulation, PHET, you will get many simulation there, and you can understand many concepts very well through this simulation activity. So student, this is the end of this lecture. So students, this is the end of the lecture. Thank you very much. And before concluding, I would like to show you my profile video.
सिटी ब्यूटीफुल चंडीगढ़, ये हैं राजकीय आदर्श विद्यालय सेक्टर 8 के राज्य पुरस्कार से सम्मानित फिजिक्स अध्यापक श्री परमजीत सिंह, जिन्होंने अपने अभिनव प्रयोगों से फिजिक्स को रोचक बनाने में प्रभावशाली कार्य किया है।
मैं फिजिक्स के प्रायोगिक पक्ष से सदैव ही रोमांचित रहा हूँ। फिजिक्स विद्यार्थियों में विज्ञान के प्रति आकर्षण और अभिरुचि उत्पन्न करने का एक सशक्त माध्यम है। वास्तव में फिजिक्स प्रकृति को समझने का एक अद्वितीय विज्ञान है।
इन्होंने समस्याओं के तकनीकी समाधान हेतु स्मार्ट फार्मिंग, गायों का अभिनव बाड़ा विषयों पर विज्ञान प्रदर्शन निर्माण में विद्यार्थियों का मार्गदर्शन करके एवं उनकी जिज्ञासा को नए पंख देकर राज्य एवं राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर सर्वश्रेष्ठ प्रदर्शन किया है। इन्होंने विद्यार्थियों के कौशल प्रदर्शन हेतु टिंकरिंग साइंस कॉर्नर, पोर्टेबल साइंस किट के रूप में मिनी प्रयोगशाला और ब्लॉग्स का विकास कर फिजिक्स अध्यापन को रोचक और असरदार बनाया है।
सो स्टूडेंट्स, टेक केयर, स्टे एट होम, स्टे सेफ, टिल नेक्स्ट वीडियो, बाय बाय, टेक केयर, गॉड ब्लेस ऑल, थैंक यू वेरी मच।